Good evening. Hong Kong has witnessed its most intense clashes since protests began 13 weeks ago. There were multiple flashpoints across the city, and tonight protesters are once again attempting to storm Hong Kong's international airport. We'll cross there live in a moment. Overnight, there were running battles outside government offices in the Admiralty District. The clashes spread to the subway system, where dozens of protesters were arrested.
This was Hong Kong's subway on Saturday night. On board, Special Tactical Squad police, as the city en route to increasingly violent confrontation. Blow upon baton blow, men and women cowering and pepper sprayed. Beaten, bloodied, 40 people arrested at Prince Edward Station alone. Two railway lines suspended just after 11 p.m, another three shut down after midnight. But seemingly no shutting down of Hong Kong's blazing political confrontation. Saturday night, there were running battles in the streets as protesters traded petrol bombs with tear gas, rubber bullets, and water cannon spray tinted in an apparent effort to mark protesters for arrest. This morning, Hong Kong's government released a statement condemning the radical protesters. Police confirming two officers fired live rounds into the air, which they characterized as warning shots. A civil rights activist characterizes events differently.
They are trying to tire the protesters out, and at the same time, they are using increasing violent tactics. For example, today they are beating people indiscriminately on the subways.
Saturday's clashes marked 5 years since China ruled out fully democratic elections for Hong Kong. Earlier in the day, tens of thousands had marched defying a government ban. Hu Shijin is editor of one of Beijing's ultra-loyal Communist Party-run newspapers.
America and Britain are interfering in Hong Kong's affairs. You are inflaming the situation. Not all these irrational emotions come from this society. Most come from foreign support.
But Joshua Wong, one of Hong Kong's leading pro-democracy activists, who was arrested on Friday and is now out on bail, is vowing to carry on. Today, writing in this opinion piece published in the New York Times, in September, the struggle will only take on more life. This evening, protesters at Hong Kong Airport already making good on that undertaking, as the face-off shows no sign of abating and metro services to the airport are suspended. Pruluan, SBS World News.
And the situation is rapidly escalating at Hong Kong Airport tonight. These pictures show a group of masked protesters storming the ground floor of Terminal 1 before they're chased away by riot police. A man is seen attempting to hide in the male toilets before being beaten by an officer with a baton. A guard was also filmed yelling at a group of female protesters hiding in the female bathroom, demanding they show their boarding pass. And these pictures are live from outside the airport, where protesters are mobilizing en masse. Passengers are already reporting disruptions.
We don't know what to do at the moment because we're so close. But at the same time, it seems like the protests are really getting pretty bad at the moment. Most of the airport is blocked off. You can't enter the airport anymore.
Well, let's go live now to SBS Dateline's Mark Fennell, who is at Hong Kong Airport and joins us now. Mark, what's happening there right now?
Well, right now, as you can see, what they've actually built on every entrance here at the airport are these huge water barricades. And in fact, that is what has managed to mostly keep protesters, rather, outside. A little bit earlier, lower on the floor, we did manage to see about 100 protesters thrust forward and then thrust backwards as riot police moved forward. It's interesting with this particular case because when it comes to the Hong Kong protests, because it's been such a sustained protest, there is in fact a Google Calendar where they announce ahead of time all of the different protests. Now, the upside of that, it means that they can amass a lot of people, but it also means that places like this here at the airport, they've had plenty of time to defend themselves, and it is already quite a defendable building. As you can see, there's police officers over my shoulder. It's likely that there will be delays, but nothing on the scale of what we saw 2 weeks ago, at least based on what we've seen so far.
Do you get a sense, Mark, that we certainly know what happened the last time the airport was targeted? Nearly 1,000 flights were cancelled. Is the sense that the police have learnt a bit more from that and that they're stopping the protesters from getting close by?
It certainly seems that the planning around this is a lot more smooth. If you go up to any entrance here, there are not only barricades, but there are also layers of security, police, in some cases, tactical unit and riot unit. So they've certainly managed to build up quite a fortification here. But what you might be able to tell, maybe not from looking at where I am right now, is the airport is full. It's full of people. So they are still managing to get passengers on, perhaps not to the same scale they would normally do so, but they've managed to withstand the protesters so far.
Mark, take us back to events from last night, which we're reporting as being one of the most violent since the protests began. Tell us what you saw. Mark, I'll just repeat that question. We seem to have a problem with the link. Tell us what you saw in last night's protest.
Anton, I believe your sound's just cut out, so I'm just going to tell you a little bit about what happened last night, and hopefully it's going to get through. Last night we were caught in between both protesters and police on the streets of Wanchai. We saw rubber bullets, water cannons, and of course tear gas being thrown. It was quite brutal. And later on in the evening, we've seen footage of people being arrested at train stations as protesters fled into the scenes. And it's worth pointing out, we've seen violence on both sides here. We've seen incredible acts of violence from the protesters' side, but of course there was that vision that has done the rounds on social media of police beating up protesters in trains as well. So the general sense here is that there is a great sense of fury in this city and an enormous amount of distrust between the Hong Kong population and their police force.
That is SBS's Mark Fennell updating us live from Hong Kong Airport.